This is the construction site for a new train station at the Gabba. And this is the construction site at Roma Street Station. It's all part of Queensland's biggest infrastructure project, the Cross River Rail. You definitely would have heard of it, at least if you live in Brisbane, and maybe you've been inconvenienced by its construction. But there's no doubt in my mind that it's a sorely needed piece of infrastructure that will have a massive impact on Brisbane, and in actual fact, all of Southeast Queensland. But how? What is it actually going to change? Do we actually need this transport upgrade? I'm Mel Pikos, and today we're talking tackle. Welcome to Talking Tactics, where we give you the news, information, and tactics that you need to thrive in the business world. If you enjoy this video, please leave a like and why not subscribe so you don't miss my next video. Now let's get into it. What is the Cross River Rail? It's a new rail line in Brisbane, stretching 10.2 kilometres from Dutton Park to Bowen Hills, and will include a 5.9 kilometre twin tunnel section under the Brisbane River and the CBD, creating a second river crossing for rail in the CBD. Its main aim is to unlock the rail bottleneck at Brisbane's only inner city river crossing, the Merivale Bridge, and will transform the way we travel across the whole of Southeast Queensland. What is being delivered? New and upgraded stations. The new 10 kilometre track and the twin tunnels under the river will form the basis of the project. The new line starts at Dutton Park Station, running underground through a number of new stations, Boggo Road, Woolloongabba, Albert Street and Roma Street. 8 existing Brisbane stations will be upgraded. The exhibition station, which will now be opened year round instead of just during the Ekka, Dutton Park, Fairfield, Maruka, Rockley, Salisbury, Yerongpilly and Yeronga. There will also be the development of 3 new Gold Coast stations, Pimpama, Hope Island and Merrimack. The precincts around these new stations form part of the government's priority development areas, meaning there will be significant upgrades in the form of residential, retail and commercial development. The line will also connect directly with the existing transport, obviously, but it will also integrate with the under construction Brisbane Metro bus with combined stations at the Gabba, Roma Street and Boggo Road. I've already made a video explaining the Brisbane Metro and how it differs and also integrates with Cross River Rail. Check it out by clicking the link up in the corner of the screen now. The construction process. Early construction works began in 2017, with major contractors starting in 2019, and at present, there are over a dozen separate work sites. The stars of the show, however, are the 2 tunnel boring machines, which dug through the rock beneath our city, creating the tunnel and lining it with strong concrete rings, unearthing tons and tons of rock and soil. The Cross River Rail YouTube channel actually has some fascinating videos on the boring machines and the process of digging the tunnels, as well as the construction progress, designs of the station, and plenty more, which I highly recommend you go and check out. Cost and delivery. The initial budget of the Cross River Rail was $5.4 billion and was set to open in late 2025. Recently, it was announced that there was a cost blowout of $960 million, meaning it will now cost $6.3 billion and will open to the public 3 months later than expected in the first quarter of 2026. From my point of view, this was to be expected. In every construction project, there are going to be some cost blowouts, especially ones of this size. They're just inevitable. And with inflation, COVID effects, supply chain impacts and the war in Europe, there are always going to be increases in cost and timeline. The state government did try to hide the increase, but I think it would be odd if this was the only project that didn't have a major cost blowout. It's better just to come clean, in my opinion. So that's what's coming. But is it necessary? Before we can really answer that, we need to have a look at how Brisbane's rail network was established and became what it is today. The first rail lines. The first rail line in Queensland began operating in July 1865 and wasn't actually in Brisbane, but Ipswich. The line into Brisbane wasn't completed until the construction of the Albert Bridge over the Brisbane River at Indooroopilly in 1875. The expansion of branch lines within the Brisbane city began in the decade following, but the Albert Bridge remained the only rail river crossing in Brisbane. The river crossings. The Merivale Bridge opened in 1978 and was the result of almost a century's worth of work trying to get Brisbane's north and south rail networks connected with a more direct route than going via Corinda. As far back as 1885, a survey was done to extend the rail from South Brisbane over the river to connect with Counter Street. Multiple routes over the river were surveyed and considered before a route was recommended, but the government decided not to proceed. The crossing was not popular with merchants operating in South Brisbane, fearing losing trade to businesses located in the centre of Brisbane City, and they lobbied hard against the bridge's construction. In the 50s, the matter was raised again, but again deferred due to financial constraints. Finally, in the 1970s, it was proposed again. The bridge was approved, then constructed, and finally opened in 1978 by Premier Joe Biocchi-Peterson. And this bridge has remained as Brisbane's only inner city rail crossing since then. And the capacity demand on the bridge has only increased with time. In 2015, official projections said that 28 trains per hour will need to cross the bridge by 2021, rising to 33 trains per hour in 2031. But the bridge can only support 24 trains per hour, and so the bottleneck of the Brisbane rail network is really beginning to strain. And those projections don't even include the rising population Brisbane has seen since COVID. Plus, the announcement of the 2032 Brisbane Olympic Games, which will see the load of the transport system intensify. The Cross River Rail Proposal. The Queensland government under Anna Bligh initially proposed Cross River Rail in 2010 to help deal with the Merivale Bridge capacity issue and overall rail network demand. This plan was tossed out by the newly elected Campbell-Newman government in 2012 in favour of their combined bus and train tunnel known as the Bat Tunnel. This would have seen a multi-level tunnel with train tracks at the bottom level and buses travelling on a level above them. This plan was in turn tossed out when Anastasia Palaszczuk became Premier in 2015 and brought back a revised Cross River Rail plan, the project currently under construction. It's now been further integrated to work in with the Brisbane Metro, so essentially it now does combine both train and bus. So what will the unlocking of the bottleneck actually mean for the people of Brisbane? For one, it will mean a much better commute. The population of Southeast Queensland is forecast to increase from 3.5 million here today to 4.9 million people in 2036. Even though over 80% of the growth is outside the Brisbane local government area, 45% of Southeast Queensland jobs will be concentrated inside the Brisbane metropolitan area. In order to connect the high growth residential areas outside of the metro area with the high growth employment centre, better transport connectivity is required. By easing the bottleneck on the bridge, commute times should be faster and less crowded, making it far easier and more comfortable for all commuters. Secondly, this line will connect with the existing transport network to create a more reliable network. It will allow for more capacity for more frequent rail services, encouraging more public transport users, which should help to ease congestion on major road arterials. And from a business perspective, the new line will connect new and expanded suburban precincts better than ever before. Around the new stations are priority development areas, which will focus on residential, commercial, and retail developments. Woolloongabba has been identified by the state government to be a key priority development area. The area will finally get a new train station with the new Cross River Rail line, and that station will connect directly with the under construction Brisbane Metro project. Then there is the redevelopment of the Gabba Stadium to become the home of the Brisbane 2032 Olympic Games. And that is kicking off a whole host of development projects. Thousands of new homes will be built in the area, including social and affordable housing with built to rent options as well. There will also be a new active travel corridor developed connecting the Gabba to South Bank and the Brisbane CBD with an alternative green corridor up along the Kangaroo Point cliffs to the CBD via the new Green Bridge, which is also currently under construction. This will mean Woolloongabba is set to boom and could possibly become Brisbane's second CBD. I've already made a video taking a closer look at Woolloongabba's future. You can check it out by clicking the link up in the corner of this video now. And other suburbs along the Cross River Rail line will also see new developments, upgrades, and renewal projects. Areas like Albion will undergo an incredible urban renewal, and we'll see businesses located there within three stops of the airport, two stops to Roma Street, three to Albert Street, and just four to the complete other side of the river. Suburbs within proximity to the new Cross River Rail line will see incredible accessibility to almost all of Brisbane. For businesses not needing to be right in the middle of the city, but still wanting the option to be connected to it, somewhere along the rail line could be be the perfect spot to set up shop. The broken airport to Gold Coast direct rail line. As part of the current rail network, there is a direct rail line travelling from the Brisbane domestic and international airport straight through the city and continuing on to the Gold Coast. No one needs to change trains, hauling heavy luggage over the other platforms and making a connection. But once Cross River Rail comes online, that changes. Instead, air train services will continue onto Ipswich after passing through the Brisbane CBD, much to the dismay of the Gold Coast Council. Why is this happening? Well, it's not a choice on a whim, but for a technical reason. Robert Dow from the lobby group Rail Back on Track explains to Brisbane Times in 2022, currently trains from the Gold Coast cross the Merivale Bridge, merge onto the CBD line, keep right on the suburban tracks and then peel off to the right onto the airport spur after Eagle Junction. But with Cross River Rail, trains from the Gold Coast will now enter the tunnel, pass through the new underground stations, pop up near Exhibition and merge in from the left to the Northern Lines. If you continue to run them to the airport, they still would need to peel off to the right to enter the airport spur. Merging from the left but peeling to the right to make the entrance onto the airport spur is a conflicting move and is apparently the equivalent of weaving across several lanes of traffic. Doing this would cause knock-on delays to all the other lines and reduce the capacity of the network, the very opposite of what this new line is aiming to do. So people going to the Gold Coast from the airport in Brisbane or back the other way will have to change trains at Roma Street, Albion or Eagle Junction, something that passengers from every other line have coped with for years and something that is no different to rail lines around the world. So what do you think? Is the Cross River Rail going to help Brisbane's transport capacity issues? Or is it a waste of money that should have gone somewhere else? I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments section down below. Thanks for watching. I'm Mel Pikos and we've been Talking Tactics.